Hi everyone, I'm Anushree and I welcome you back to my channel. I am recycling an old earphone box today and this video is going to be so much fun. Most of you already know that I'm a guest designer for Little Birdie Crafts, and for today's box makeover, I'll be using all products from Little Birdie Crafts. They have an amazing range of products which you should definitely check out on their site. So sit back, relax and enjoy the video while I turn my camera to my table. Meanwhile, if you're new to the channel, do subscribe the channel for more crafty videos and hit the bell icon for all future video notifications. So let's begin the fun. All products used in this video are from Little Birdie Crafts. Here are some pictures of my finished recycled altered box. Isn't it looking pretty? There are so many beautiful elements combined here. I'll be leaving links of all products and Little Birdie Crafts site below in the description. So let's learn how to make it from scratch now. My box is here and I need to empty out whatever's there. There are some papers, a foam pad. This is my box bottom and this is the lid of the box. There's a handle here which I do not need. The surface looks good to me now to start. I'm starting with white gesso as my foundation. This is a white water-based opaque primer and is good to be applied on most of the surfaces like metal, glass, cardboard, anything is fine. I have used it on many surfaces and it comes out pretty well. So you can see it's ready. I have put 2 coats of gesso on this. Next, I'm using Sparkle Paste Passion Pink along with Charming Bloom Stencil. This is a 4x4 inches stencil and is perfect for painting designs on furniture, wall, clothing, glass, cards, bags, and many more. I'll start with the top right of my lid. I'm applying the paste using a painting knife. It's looking so pretty and the sparkle is really popping out. I'll apply a little on the bottom left also. So this side is also ready. I want to apply a little paste on my sides also so that it looks like a complete panel. I'll just cover a small portion on the sides. Off screen, I covered these 2 sides with the sparkle paste and the same stencil. Now it's time to use the chipboard. This one is Garden Greens chipboard and has 2 pieces of these leaves. Now I'm using Home Decor Chalk Paint Wild Wasabi on top of this. If you want, you can even apply some gesso before applying any chalk paints or any kind of paints. I'm going to put this chalk paint directly on my chipboard. And here you can see they look awesome after drying. Next, I'm using Poppies and Roses Elements Pack. This pack has 52 pieces of varieties of roses and poppies designs. They all have some glitter on it that makes it look so pretty. Now I have this black chipboard along with heavy gel medium gloss to give volume on this frame. Now this heavy gel medium is a transparent, flexible, extra heavy body acrylic gel. I am using it as a glue here and it also will give some volume to it. Now next I'm using Metal Microbeads Summer Gold.
So the places where I have applied this heavy gel medium, rather than using other glues, I am using this gel which will cover the metal beads and they will stick easily on the panel. Let's keep this aside. Okay, the metal beads are all stuck on it and now it's time to stick or adhere these element sheets also. I'm again using the heavy gel for this. If you want, you can use other glues like Fevicol or even silicone glue to stick these elements back. To increase the volume on the frame, I'm using a 300 GSM chipboard. This is black GSM, black chipboard, I'm sorry. I'll stick two in such a way that next when I'm sticking something, you can see it all uplifted. That is also one way of creating volume. Let's stick this cute butterfly here. I'm trying to keep it a Valentine's theme, so I'll stick to red and orange, green colors. I want to give some glitter feel to my leaves also, so I'm applying this heavy gel again on this green chipboard. I'm using Blanche Fiesta. Now there are these six bottles of glitters, varieties of glitters are there. I'm using this thin, very fine glitter. So after the heavy gel is applied there, just simply go ahead and put the glitter on it. It will stick on it, stick on the chipboard very easily. Let me show you how I have done it on that one. Here we go. I haven't applied on the full of the chipboard because I want a small amount of glitter only. Can you see after drying it looks so pretty? Let's start sticking it to the frame. I'm using Fevicol now to stick my chipboard. So chipboards are all stuck now. They are looking so pretty. So time to put some sentiment. I have these Love Forever Jute sentiments. There are some beautiful words and quotes here. I have flowers, I have leaves, I have the sentiment with butterfly and microbeads. It's all looking very pretty. Now it's time to do some fillings on the sides also. So these white portions should be covered with something. So there are so many elements. I chose to go ahead with one butterfly on this side. And this clock is also there. So I'll cut it into this size to fit my side there. I'm again using the heavy gel to stick this element sheet on my box. Sides are covered. Now I want to cover the top as well. So there's this another element sheet. Let's just hide this handle portion. I could have cut this portion before also, but I wanted to keep it precise how much I need it. Off screen, I have also put these beautiful roses, which are again from Little Birdie Crafts. This is a pigment ink pad. Now there are three colors in one single pack. I want to distress the sides. Now this is looking a little plain white to me, So just to give a little color, this pigment ink pad is very cool and very nice. You can use these ink pads in a lot of card making and everything. So even in these kind of projects, these ink pads have a lot of use. I have done my lid. Now I want to use this Celebrate Life paper pack. Now there's a tag sheet there. I have put that one inside, and on the edges I'm again using the pigment ink, that's that pink color, with the foam applicator. So my box is complete and I'm loving it. If you have also enjoyed the video, subscribe the channel for more crafty fun, and do not forget to hit the bell icon to receive future video notifications. Thanks again for watching. See you soon with my next video. Bye-bye.